So I know when I was first starting out, I totally thought that an artist just made a few paintings and then there were collectors chomping at the bit all around them to buy it all as fast as they could. False. So when I was just a teeny tiny little young birdie just starting out back in high school and even early college, I literally thought that an artist really was only an artist if they made paintings and then they got into a gallery and this gallery sold their artwork and to collectors and that was it. And that was literally the life cycle of an artist and that was how things were done. But I had so much to learn. Now granted, this is before social media, but the same was true back then, that there are a lot more avenues than just simply getting into a gallery and selling to collector A and B. That's just not how it usually works. I honestly thought that once I got to a certain point of professionalism in my art that I could just walk into any gallery and say, here's my paintings, and they would be like, great, let us represent you, and it would just be as simple as that, no problems whatsoever. But in reality, it's way harder than that, and you don't just walk into any place and say, here's my art. Galleries, just like anyone else, want to make sure that they're hiring or working with you if you are going to be successful. So building up your own sort of following, having a few people that have already collected your artwork if possible, making yourself known in any kind of way, any kind of name recognition, even if it's local press, really helps you out both then and now. It's much better if you can have some kind of name recognition before trying to apply to any place professional. And then once I got out and had my bachelor's degree, I kind of felt a little bit more confident to go out and start sharing my art with the world, but I was still a little bit apprehensive, you know, of applying to any place professional just because I didn't have any history. So what did I do? I went out and I started creating my own art events. I would collaborate with friends, we would curate each other's shows, we would have art in each other's shows, we would have musicians, we would have crafters, and we would hold them in local establishments, not necessarily in art galleries, but in all kinds of creative spaces all over. I just became very active in the art community and decided that I was gonna build up a name for myself before trying to rely on any other representation building up my name for me. Once I started collaborating with other artists and creating some of my own art events and actually selling some of my artwork as well as selling artwork for other people, I quickly learned that I really needed to know about marketing and bookkeeping. And most visual artists cringe at those words, but I wish that I had realized that in college to take at least one marketing or bookkeeping class or something like that. Luckily, I did wind up being able to get some good advice from some other artists as well as my mom, who's a business owner, but those were two skills that I really had to sort of crash course learn because I wanted to make sure that I was getting the right amount of money for my artwork so that I'm able to sustain myself making it. And I want to make sure that if I'm putting on events and working with other artists that I'm doing the best that I can to make sure that people show up to support all of us. And of course, marketing is totally essential for any kind of online presence too. So marketing and bookkeeping, any kind of classes, online courses, just do it. You will never ever regret having those skills. I also learned while promoting my own artwork and these art shows that nobody is going to get excited about your artwork unless you are excited about your artwork. So I learned the true value of being your own advocate, being enthusiastic, being excited, telling people about your artwork with a big smile on your face, because then they're going to get excited to take part in your art journey too. Because if there's one thing I've learned, if you are not excited about your artwork, nobody else is going to care either. Now, one thing I noticed, which I'm sure you do too, is that somewhere along the way on your art journey, people start to really recognize that you are actually factually trying to do this as a plausible career. And then the advice starts happening. Oh boy. So I do appreciate advice, especially when I've asked for it, but you will get all kinds of advice from all kinds of people, whether or not you ask for it, including the advice of, hey, why don't you find a real job? So what I finally learned after many years of taking advice from all over the place and sometimes making myself very anxietal about my choice as an artist, I finally learned to only take advice from people who are in the career path that you want to be in. It's very simple for someone who is not a professional creative or artist to sit here and tell you what you should do with your life, or if it's a good decision or worth it, or if you're wasting your time or any of those kind of things. But if they are not professional creatives in some way, they're not going to be able to give you real feedback. Even if they're people that love you very much and are maybe trying to help, you need to make sure to look to people that are in the path and that are achieving the success that you want to achieve. And make sure that you are listening to people whose path you yourself would like to follow. Don't take advice from people whose career you don't choose to follow. Take advice from people who you want to be like. So after being out of college for a few years and having put on some art shows and being in the local newspaper and kind of, you know, getting my name out there a little bit, selling a little bit of artwork here and there, I started realizing that the best way for me to ingratiate myself further into a local artistic community was to say yes to as many things as possible. As many opportunities came my way, I said yes to. Now that does not mean giving away free art. That's not an opportunity. But what it does mean is teaching some classes that maybe I was a little nervous about teaching, but hey, if somebody asks you to do something, normally they believe in you and you can do it. Or perhaps it was helping out with an art show that might not have been in my main vein, but hey, I was able to meet some really great people, you know, or sometimes just contributing and handing out flyers or helping somebody else get their event known. Trying to be a yes person makes you likable and essential to your local artistic community. And I do focus on the local artistic community because especially when you are starting out, people are going to be far more invested in you and your artwork if they have met you in person. If they're just scrolling on their phone and you don't have like the top artwork of anyone ever in the world, like some of these greatest artworks ever, you're gonna get lost in the shuffle. So as we are starting out, make sure you're being realistic about your audience, and your audience that's gonna advocate and love you most is gonna be the audience that meets you in person. So focusing on that local community, saying yes to local things, being out there, encouraging other artists, that's what's gonna get you very first noticed and appreciated online, and then your community will grow from there as you improve as an artist, as well as your circle grows, and then you naturally become more built up online in a digital community, and people who don't know you immediately will eventually start to see you too. Be active in your local artistic community. Even if it's a small town situation, there's nothing world famous that's gonna happen, that's okay. Being in that community, pumping each other up, helping each other out, and actually seeing how this whole process works as a group, making new friends, being in a creative space, it's just going to enliven not only your artistic business, but it's going to inspire you. You're gonna wind up finding new things that you're gonna wanna do with your artwork. I just cannot tell you enough that being active in a local community is one of the very best ways for a new artist to grow. Luckily, that was one thing that I definitely did figure out early on, and I had a blast doing it. Once I really started to put my artwork online in a big way, I learned that there are a myriad of other skills to learn when it comes to being a professional artist. Here I was, just some kid, thinking that if I could draw, paint, and get people excited about an art event, I would have my work cut out for me. False. Again. No. I've had to teach myself about writing about my artwork, graphic design, website hosting, photography and videography, editing, HTML and some tiny code stuff. So many skills that I would have never thought I would have needed to know to be a visual artist using traditional materials. It's absolutely astounding. And I feel like I was a little late to the game learning some of these things, but you don't have to be. And don't forget, while you're learning and using all these skills, you also need to be your own documentarian so that you can film the entire behind the scenes process as well. After going to graduate school about 5 years ago, I kind of thought I was done with my education. But now in these last few years, I have truly come to the realization that what sets apart good artists from great artists is that great artists never stop learning. They never stop practicing. They never stop seeking that extra bit of knowledge. And if they have come to a standstill in what they can learn on their own, they will go and get higher education or have a consultant, get some sort of mentorship. They will go and get the knowledge that they need to get. There's no end, there's no ceiling, there's no finish point to the knowledge that we can all gain as artists. People from major artists or creatives to celebrities to even hedge fund managers, when they need it, they ask for help, they seek out help, they gain some knowledge. So if you think you're at a place in your own artistic journey that you need a little guidance from someone who's been there and done that, lucky for you, I have got mentorship packages on my website and I am available to work one-on-one via Zoom with you. I'd love to be able to help you out with all of your art biz questions. Thanks for being here, guys. I'll see you super soon. Jump down below and check out those links for all my mentorship packages.